Hey everybody, Sam Davidson here with MEA Worldwide, and I am so excited because I am sitting here with Carly Hughes, who plays Angela on ABC's hit show American Housewife. How are you doing?
I'm great. I'm happy to be here.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Happy 2020.
It's a very exciting time because American Housewife is coming back.
Yes.
Very soon.
It January is. We got January 17th, and we got six more episodes at it, so.
And I had an amazing time binging over the past couple of weeks. I'm a big fan of the show now. So I know that you are like a Broadway baby. Like, you really have done some amazing work, and you were on Broadway while you landed this role. So tell me a little bit about that.
I had finished my, I closed out my run as leading player in Pippin and took over as Velma Kelly in Chicago on Broadway. And then I left that and did Cabin in the Sky, which was a revival of an older musical. And opening night of Cabin in the Sky, you know, it was pilot season. So that we opened February or something, and it's pilot season, you're auditioning left and right. And I had an audition, and I was like, man, I don't feel like going, I'm so tired. Because we have opening night, so we rehearsed 12 to 6, and my audition was at 6:30. So I got on the A train, I ran over to ABC, I did my audition, and I was like, great. And they were like, do you want to try it again? And I was like, yeah, oh, no, I can't. I have to go because my half hour is in 10 minutes. And I ran back to the theater and forgot about it. And then a couple days later, into that week, they were like, you're pinned for this TV show. And I was like, oh, my God, what does that mean? Because I had no idea. And they're like, you're pinned to test. We'll find out in 2 days. And then I found out I tested. They flew me out to test out here. And then we waited another week and a half, and then found out I booked it. And I was like, okay. I'll take that.
I mean, what an amazing first series regular role on television. And, you know, so many shows die
right? And don't make it. Or or let alone a show dying. Like, you get the pilot and then all of a sudden it's not a show.
Exactly.
They're like, no room for that.
And there are so many episodes of this. So when you first got to set, did you feel that feeling like this could really last a long time?
No, because coming from theater, nothing is nothing until it's something. And even then on Broadway, you like open a show and you bow and you have audiences, and then like you could close the next week and you're like, what? How? So my mentality is that New Yorker hustle mentality of like, I'm grateful, I'm glad we're doing it, I'm not going to settle until I feel settled. So I was just grateful and honored and excited, but I wasn't like, we've made it, because I also feel like sometimes that's a way to jinx it.
Jinx, right?
You know, when you're like,
sorry, we didn't make it. Well, Angela is such an amazing character. She is a woman of color that is queer.
Yeah.
And so what kind of feedback have you gotten from that community? Have you been reached out to by any fans?
It's interesting because it's a tricky thing these days. You know what I mean?
Yes.
You have to be extra sensitive to everyone's opinions and feelings and approach it, you know, the right way. And I just have constantly been aware and tried to... I'm not Carly playing Angela as the lesbian. I'm just playing a human being, is what I always say. A human being who happens to be a lesbian, who happens to be a black girl in Connecticut, who happens to be a divorcee with two kids. So I think if you are not trying to play it up and you're being a person, then you're being honest and truthful. And so the feedback has been lovely. I've gone to events for LGBTQ and everything, where they've been like, it's so nice to see you and see us represented on screen. And some of them don't know that I'm not a lesbian, and some of them do. Most of them do, I think. And it's not an issue. They're just like, thank you for representing us, which makes me go, oh, okay, I'm doing it correctly.
Yeah.
I don't want to mock anyone. I wouldn't want to mock anyone, straight, gay, or otherwise. Mm-hmm. I just want to try to be as honest as I can. And so to hear that from them makes me go, okay. I'm doing a good job.
And tell me about the chemistry you have with the two other women. Did you guys do a chemistry test at all?
We never did, but we're goofballs.
Yeah.
Like, it seems like we did a chemistry test, but we've just gotten along from the pilot. We all auditioned at separate times, never together, and we didn't meet until first day of filming. And then it just, like, fell into place. We, like, laughed about everything, and now, four seasons in between takes, they have to be like, girls! Stop giggling, you know, because we're laughing at just everyday life. And
Ali Wong is one of my favorite comics.
She's amazing.
So have there been times on set, I mean, that she's just like really like putting on a show, cracking you guys up? Or is it kind of just everybody in their
element? It's just everybody. And mainly, like, when I say mainly when we're laughing, we're literally laughing at each other, at something we've said or something we've talked about. So, which is also cool mm-hmm. because it doesn't have to be an act or a show the whole time. We enjoy each other's company and we're laughing at everything. But the best is when, for me, in any time, but especially when Ali gets the giggles, because when I get the giggles on stage, like on a Broadway stage, I'm the worst. I can't stop. And I'm like, live audience and my shoulders are going and trying to sing. It's the worst because I'm like, it's live, I know you saw that was funny, but at least on TV and film you can be like, okay, everybody hold until we like stop.
Yeah. Well, you guys did a musical number on the mid-season finale, so did you pitch that to them? Did they pitch it to you wanting you to be a part of that?
Well, we it was kind of like collaborative in terms of once they realized who they had and who else they had on the show that could sing, they were like, oh, maybe we should do a musical episode. And we thought that, you know, it was talked about season one and we were like, yeah, and then it didn't happen season one. Mm-hmm. And then we did it season two and we were all like, oh, this was fun, but it takes a lot of work. I mean, if you don't come from that world of theater and live performances, you know, and then adding in a camera crew and dancers mm-hmm. and all that, you kind of don't know what you're in for until you get there. But it still was magical, and they had Meg, me and Meg and little Julia sings as well, and Katie. So they hit the jackpot with all of us. And we got original songs that were written by Glenn Slater and Justin Paul, who was part of the team that wrote Dear Evan Hansen, mm-hmm. you know, in Greatest Showman. So we were lucky.
Yeah, it was a really fun moment. Hope to see more of that.
Yeah,
for
I know.
Sure.
I know.
And so obviously the show is a comedy, but it has touched on some, you know, really important issues.
Yeah.
Are there any that you're specifically proud of that the show has tackled or that we might see coming up that you're excited about?
I like when they delve into the teenage problems. Mm-hmm. I mean, most recently there was one where the oldest daughter, McDonnelly, who plays Taylor, was contemplating having sex for the first time. Mm-hmm. That happens. And she couldn't talk to her mom, which also happens. And so she came to my character and asked for me to get her birth control, of which I was like, you know, Angela's like, yeah, okay, let's do it. And it started a tiff between Katie and I, which was understandable because she's like, it's my child, I should do that. And Angela's standpoint was, but would you? No. Mm-hmm. And she felt like she couldn't come to you. And did you want me not to do it? And she just has sex. So there's two sides, three sides to everything. And it's about maneuvering it, what's best for the child and life. Figuring out it takes a village.
Yeah.
It actually does, and that was one example of that, you know.
And these kids have grown up so fast.
So fast.
I know, it's crazy.
So, I mean, so fast that's, you know, I mean, I'm glad it's an open topic now, but it's, I think the world we live in today, with everyday life and the politics and just everything mixed in, they are kind of forced to grow up faster mm-hmm. than we had to grow up. And so you have to be on top of it. And you also have to have a more open mind than our parents ever did.
Yeah.
You know, our parents were, no, my way or the highway. And you can't be that mm-hmm. now.
And, you know, the kids are getting closer to college. Do you think that the show can go on and could possibly go on once the kids leave?
I think so. I mean, I'm not sure. That's always so tricky because it's like, it depends on everyone in real life behind the scenes, and it also depends on what direction do you want the show to take? Do you mm-hmm. want it to stay in this Westport High School realm, or do you want it to have a life beyond that, or do you want it to be remembered for, you know? And so there's honestly no way to know. If we did, obviously, yes. Taylor trying to maneuver college, hilarious.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Daniel, who plays Oliver, trying to get into Harvard, hilarious. And little Julia, who plays Anna Cat, running the roost. Yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously, everyone, I would want to see that. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, I don't know. And also, there's something to be said for ending and going out at a good time.
Right.
Again, I don't know when that is. But, yeah. You know, it's finding all of that.
Yeah, absolutely. And so the second half of the fourth season is coming out next week. What can you tease us about it and about what your character is going to be going through?
Okay, so we shoot a lot of episodes we shoot them in out of order, and then they air out of the order we shoot them in. So sometimes we're like, oh, what? That's cool. Because we may have shot it like 4 months ago. So I'm not sure what they're leading in with, but I know going back into the season, they're going to try to expand a little bit more on our characters, which would be great for everyone mm-hmm. to see. We've gotten to see Angela outside of the second breakfast table.
Mm-hmm.
And at her office, and more about her being a lawyer. And I think they're wanting to explore her dating life, which is always hilarious to me. And we always talk about her kids, but we've never seen them. They're never in the picture. Right. So I'm like, can we show my kids? Yeah. Like, that I have them for real? Because that would be fun, and it would be another, you know, plot line of to get, you know, to binge on. So I think they're going to explore, maybe not both, maybe both.
Yeah.
But there's some teasers in there about that, and that would be exciting.
And besides this show, of course, what else is coming up for you? I know you had a role in Insatiable.
Yeah, Curb. I had Insatiable. They just finished season two, and that was the last season for them. Curb was hilarious because it was a year and a half ago, but I got to work with Lin, who is a friend of mine, Lin Manuel, but we ironically didn't get to work together on Broadway, but we worked together on TV doing a Broadway show.
It's so Hollywood.
We were like, hey, so great to work, and I've known him since, gosh.
Oh, just two, Lin, you know? Oh my God, it's so funny.
Before everyone was like, Lin Manuel Miranda, he was like Lin, and he was one of us, and we all got to the city around the same time, so my Broadway debut was Putnam County Spelling Bee, and he was in the audience for like my first show on. I was a standby and I went on, no rehearsal or anything. And I remember him being like, you did great. Before he was, you know, Lin Manuel.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh yeah, and you're friends with my friend, so we know each other that way. And now he is who he is. And I was like, he saw my Broadway debut.
That's amazing.
I know. But yeah, so there'll be more of that. And I'm working on a Christmas album that I was going to say next year, but it's 2020, so
yeah.
This year.
So, wow.
Get that together.
Yeah, I know you just said you loved Christmas before we went on air.
I'm obsessed with Christmas.
That's perfect.
I know. I did a single for an EP, but you have to mix them and getting everyone in the same place at the same time, but yeah.
Yeah. And so will you be returning to Broadway, you think, anytime soon?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard with the schedule, with the filming schedule. We film one episode a week.
Yeah.
And right now it's, 21 episodes, so that'll take us through March. Mm-hmm. And so timing-wise, that's when everything is already in previews, getting ready for the Tonys. So it's really just about the right show, but also timing.
Yeah.
And what'll work. But there are some shows that I can go in and pop in. Like, sometimes you go back into Chicago if you've done it already. They'll have you back for, like,
I love that show.
A little stint. I know, it's so fun.
Yeah.
And those are easy to be like, I need to get my Broadway fill, and then you do something for, like, your hiatus.
That's so fun.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for joining
us. Thanks for having me.
Of course.
This is fun.
Everyone, make sure to catch up on American Housewife on ABC. You can find it streaming, and make sure to tune in to the second part of season 4,
yeah.
January 17th.
Yeah.
All right. We'll see you next time. Bye, guys.